we've seen in any contest so far, and he's kept a lot of it, I think, for the very last contest of his career.
Yeah, great counterpunch boxing here from Kindlin. He won the round 11-5, and Khan just slipping away slightly, you have to say, but what a lovely 1-2 that was from Kindlin, making his opponent miss, and then he's back to it, he's back at him. That's great counterpunching. He's a master at it, he really is. Khan cannot afford to fall short. Got to get the feet there, double up the attacks.
Well, he's not doing that much wrong, but they're giving him a little bit of a telling off. I don't know why. Amir Khan really now has it all to do. It was always going to be a massive task. It was always going to be a massive task to get to these Olympics and to get to the final. He has done absolutely splendidly. So here we go again. Halfway point of this 60-kilogram final. The man who was the champion 4 years ago and aiming to be the champion here in Athens, Mario Cesar Kindlin Mesa. 15-9 up against the teenager from Bolton, Amir Khan. Quicker hands once again by Kindlin, and it's that right round the corner, just out of the vision of Amir Khan, is causing him all the problems. Kindlin just stepping away to his right, and as he does so, he throws the shot. It's a very clever piece of footwork and hand speed.
Yeah, his movement is superb. You know, you have to give him a lot of credit. What he actually does also, he's not only a good counter puncher, he's a great counter attacking fighter. He beats his opponents to the punch there. There was another typical example there with the left. His timing and vision really is excellent.
Good footwork by Cannon again. There's that right hand, and look how quick Kindlin is. 9 points the gap now. And maybe Amir really just has to take a chance. He's got to hope for the sort of shot that stopped the Korean in his tracks in his quarter final. Better work by Khan, he's picked one up still. 8 points between them. Clever little sighting shot into the ribs by the wily Kindlin. Khan replies.
Very important that Khan doesn't get frustrated here, and he's boxing okay, but he's just got to up the work rate without getting frustrated, because that's when he'll make mistakes, and that's what Kindlin's depending on.
Good shot by Khan. He needs a couple more to give him any chance in the last round. There's, well, eight between them. Once again, Khan, but wonderful blocking by Kindlin. Just swatted the British boxer's hands away. Khan steps in, he's closed it to seven. Now, come on, Amir. Two, three more, if you can manage it, would be just a ticket. Glanced over at Terry Edwards. He'll have a word with him in just a second or so. And look, right at the end of the round, when he needed it most, just to deny Khan any genuine chance, Kindlin steps in with a scoring shot. Another great run by Kindlin, much, much closer. Well, Billy Walsh, the Irish national coach who's helping out in the British corner, because as a one boxer, one coach said, you need a big last round. I think that's the understatement of the century.
He lost that round 8-5, didn't he? But I think he's boxing well, Amir. He can't get frustrated. Can't afford himself to make the mistakes, but he's just got to up the work rate and just try and vary things a little bit. A few feints here and there, maybe. But he's up against a 33-year-old Olympic champion. I mean, he was always going to be a tall order, but hey, these are the Olympics, and good luck to him in that last round.
Well, this is going to be the last time we will see Mario Cesar Kindlin Mesa in a boxing tournament. I'm hoping that we will see lots more of Amir Khan. He is a precious, precocious talent that has to be nurtured and cultivated. And all the inducements are understandable. But in 4 years' time, after the Beijing Olympics, he will still only be 21 years of age. And we were speaking earlier to Evander Holyfield, who reckons 21 is not a bad time in which to turn pro. Great right hand once again by Kindlin. Opened up a gap of 8 points. And Kindlin has kept his very best for his very last contest and his second Olympic final. And all those years of experience and ring craft and work and everything the Cubans do day in, day out, eat, sleep, breathe boxing.
That was a great right hand from Khan there. Just stepped in with a punch, beat his opponent to it. Lovely shot.
Kindlin just being that little bit too clever. Wonderful counter-punching. Amir Khan knew he'd been up against a master. couple of months ago when they met in a friendly. This is not a friendly. There's gold and silver to be decided. Great finish by Kahn. He's got him with a great right hand. That's the first time I think I've seen for, well, maybe 7 or 8 years, and he's caught him again. Well, if there were 4 more rounds, I think Kahn could win this one. What a display he's giving us. It's not going to be gold for Amir Kahn unless he knocks Kindlen out. And nobody's done that. He's caught him again. 9 points between them. Amir Kahn is giving it a terrific last round.
Well, he has the ability, the natural ability, just to suss out his opponent. He's come a little bit too late in this contest, but hey, great performance from Amir Kahn.
Coming up to the final 15 seconds, 9 points between them. Amir Kahn took the opening round 4-3, but then the maestro upped the work rate, and he's just moving away now. He knows he's got a second successive gold medal. He knows he's going to retire as a Cuban national hero. But what Amir Kahn has done has made him a British hero. This has been a great performance by the youngest British boxer ever to win a medal. The third youngest boxer in the tournament. He's against one of the oldest and certainly one of the most experienced and one of the best. And we've said before that this man has not just been the best man in his division in the world for 7 or 8 years. He's been the best boxer in amateur terms in the world for 7 or 8 years. He retires undefeated. Mario Cesar, Kindlen and Mesa. But what a contest he was given. What a terrific last round. And if I'm not mistaken, Richie Woodall, it was an even last round.
Even Stephen last round, yeah, 8 apiece. And this guy, Amir Kahn, can be proud of himself. The whole of Britain's proud of him because he's had a fantastic games. And, you know, a star is born here.
This is a wonderful moment. A wonderful moment. It was always going to be very difficult. We were all hoping that something could be pulled out of the fire for Amir Kahn, but Mario Kindlen didn't douse his fire, but he kept him under control. And Mario Kindlen is the champion yet again. A double Olympic gold medalist, a triple world champion, Mario Kindlen. We will not see him again. I hope and pray that we'll be seeing this man in the vest of Britain for many years to come, for at least 4, because we could do with a bit of a boost, just like the one he has provided us with so far. Terrific performance by Amir Kahn, but beaten by the best man in the world, pound for pound, kilogram for kilogram, 5 goals for Cuba, and this is one of the greatest Cuban boxers of all time. Well, it's nice to see him smile. He really has been old stone face himself. There hasn't been a single flicker of emotion. Now he can let it go. Now he can relax. And now he can enjoy his moment. And it is his moment. Well, what a great sequence by Amir Kahn. He won the first round. He shared the last rounds 2 and 3. Well, the old maestro really put on the foot on the gas. But what a great finish by Amir Kahn. Had he had a little bit more, had this been 3-3s, who knows? Amir Kahn might have been right up there and have taken this man even closer than he did. It's been a wonderful, wonderful boxing tournament for Amir Kahn in Britain. And there was a look of sheer surprise on the face of Mario Kindlen as our little boy caught him. What a great display by Amir Kahn. Gave it everything for 4 rounds. Well, I think he knows, Kindlen knows, that Amir Kahn is an enormous talent, and there's great respect there for the two of them. The Cubans very delighted, very relieved. This man was the gold medal favorite from Sydney 4 years ago. He justified everything that was written and said about him. He had to work extremely hard against the teenager from Bolton, number one in the world Mario Kindlen, but number two in the world by not a very big distance is Amir Kahn. Terrific display by Mario Kindlen, as we expected. We knew he'd been keeping a bit in reserve. He's pipped Amir Kahn, and a very happy silver medalist is with Gary Richardson.